Spacious skies of fruited plain, the rights and freedoms we retain, the privilege we hold just to live in this great land. Do we recognize it as a gift from God? America, bless God. It is He that hath made us, and not we ourselves. Every blessing that we own is a mercy from His throne. America, bless God. We try to rewrite history and praise ourselves for being free. We take unto ourselves the glory due to God. How long can we expect Him to restrain His chastening? America, bless God. It is He that hath made us, and not we ourselves. Every blessing that we own is a mercy from His throne. America, bless God.
And those of you who pressed into service to celebrate America's independence, thank you very much for coming. All of the diplomatic corps, all of the ambassadors, Hershey Kyoga, who was our dean of the diplomatic corps from Palau, where is it? Somewhere here. Will everybody say thank you to him for all of his years of service? A big applause for Hershey Kyoga. One thing we will absolutely not do is ruin the evening with a long speech, okay? I promise you that. I wanted to have a chance to welcome everybody. I wasn't able to be here last year. I celebrated the 4th of July with a concierge at the hotel in Vienna who was dressed in these wild blue starry pants. And we had a hamburger cookout right in the middle of Vienna where we celebrated the 4th of July as we went another 10 days in the negotiations of the Iran deal. And all of us had expected to be back here in order to celebrate. No fireworks, folks, but different kind of fireworks, I should say. Different kind of fireworks. But it really is a pleasure. If I could be chauvinistic just for a slight minute, and I really mean only for a minute. The tradition of celebrating the 4th of July began almost immediately after the Declaration of Independence. And many people view, you know, there's a distinction. The Declaration of Independence was a declaration. And that's always marked what everybody says was the beginning of the United States or the beginning of America. And in reality, the Declaration was written about 2 years earlier and worked on and then finally was signed later afterwards. But it was published on the 4th when the folks in Philadelphia actually voted it out. And it got so much coverage when it was published that that's been the date that's marked. Even though It wasn't, in fact, signed until August, and of course, the Constitution came into effect much, much later, and there were the years of the war. In 1777, we were fighting a war. In 1778, we were fighting a war. 1781, the Battle of Yorktown, which is greatly celebrated in the musical Hamilton. How many of you have heard the music of the musical Hamilton? Great. And you know there's that wonderful moment when King George comes out on stage in Hamilton. It's a very funny moment. It's one of the funniest in the show. And he sings this ditty, "You'll Be Back." Well, of course, we didn't go back. He was wrong. But it's a wonderful underscoring of the nature of the formation of a country. And I say this, are thousands of years old, and older than us. We are now 240 years old, which is not that old, correct? So we always have to have a proper measured amount, believe me, of humility as we talk about our own history. And whenever I go to the Middle East and I'm talking in one of the countries there, I am so cognizant, or Europe, or so many other places, 1,000 years of history as nations and so forth. But for us, obviously, this is still special. I want to just say one thing as we celebrate this 4th of July. I'm leaving tomorrow. I see the ambassador from Georgia here. I'm going to Georgia. I'm going to Ukraine, and then I go to Poland for the summit of NATO. I come back, and I race back over, which is the nature of the challenges today. I know the news is sometimes really hard to listen to or watch or read. But I want everybody to focus on reality on this 4th of July. As we celebrate our independence, and you, many of us, a number of you came up, Georgia celebrating 25 years of independence. There are all kinds of celebrations taking place around the world, a world that has many more democracies today than we had 30 years ago, that has many fewer nuclear weapons today than we had 30 years ago. And we are on the cusp, believe it or not, of the first AIDS-free, born-free of AIDS generation in history. We have, if you're a child born somewhere today, I know it doesn't seem this way with so many refugees and with the plight of Israel and Syria and the numbers of migrants pouring into Europe and the challenge of Africa. But the fact is, there are more people today, young people going to school. If you're a young person born today, you're more likely to be fed, more likely to have vaccinations, more likely to go to school, and more likely to live a longer life than at any time in history. And for the first time in human history that we know it since we measure it, the severest rate of poverty is now gone below 10% for the first time in our history. So yes, bombs go off in places. And that's the acts of desperation of people who are confronting the march of history, watching what modernity is doing, changes that are taking place with globalization, and they're fighting back against unemployment and other problems. But fewer people are dying today of violence, nation on nation, than at any time in the last century.
Recognize it as a gift from God.
blessing that we own is a mercy from His throne. America, bless God. We try to rewrite history and praise ourselves for being free. We take unto ourselves the glory due to God. How long can we expect Him to restrain His chastening rod? America, and not we ourselves. Every blessing that we own is a mercy from throne, amen.